burning them, burning them. Yes.
See, you see that? You see? Now it's that. You see your equality that you got inside you for the speaker, for the person that's up there? Because the God of earth should not have to be yelling and screaming to make himself or herself heard in this auditorium. A lot of us come in this auditorium and we want to socialize in the auditorium. The auditorium is to sit down and listen to the person that's giving their presentation back to you. That's what we call mutual respect. And we have that mutual respect amongst each other. There's no brother or sister got to get up there getting hoarse to express themselves to us. When you want to socialize, that's what the hallway is for. That's what the cafeteria is for. When you come in here, you're supposed to show your respect. When you in here, you say you want to listen. When you sit in those chairs, you say you want to listen. You don't say you want to come in here and run your mouth. That's for the hallway. And the auditorium in the street and everywhere else. Y'all are supreme beings. Y'all saints, y'all are supreme beings. Supreme beings got supreme intelligence. Intelligence means to be smart. You show your intelligence by what you do. The world watching you, just like you watching things, things is watching you. So what you showing people? You saying one thing and doing another, it don't mesh. It don't make sense. Come on, let's be for real with ourselves. If you don't want to socialize, go out there and socialize. Give the person here a proper respect. When that God spoke, y'all shut up. I saw the equality that y'all gave back to him. Ain't nobody was whispering a word. That's how it's supposed to be. Whether the person is a low speaker or the person is a high speaker, the point is what you just did is what you're supposed to do always. What y'all just did just now, y'all showed your equality to the speaker. That's what you're supposed to do, not sometimes. All the time, God's mercy. The auditorium is where you sit and listen to the person at the mic making their presentation, not when you come in here and yell and scream. Divine equality seat. See how we define. Now let's build a story. What is the duty of a civilized person? The duty of a civilized person is to teach people who establish civilization, righteousness, knowledge of themselves, and the science of everything in life, so they can get some love and peace and happiness in their life. That's our job. We have to build with this knowledge, dog. We can't just talk about it. We got to be about it. And this is each and every day, man. Every minute of the day, every second of the day. And you can't go crazy with it, though some of us do bug out. Because we just can't take it. You got to be strong in your head. The God said, arm, leg, leg. Arm, leg, leg, arm, supreme head. You got to be strong in your head. So that you don't bug out in these days and times. You can't let drugs bug you out. Too many of us are drug addicts. We can't wait to run to the damn hitman. Give me a hit. We pull out $5 in a minute. Give me a hit. We can't wait to put some powder up our nose. We can't wait. A lot of us is a bunch of drug addicts. A lot of us is a bunch of alcoholics. We can't wait to run down to the liquor store and talk about, I'm going to the L.I. And we'll pull out $5 in a minute to get a bottle so we can throw down our damn trunks and stagger through the street and then try to talk about the manager and tell everybody the 5% is supreme. What 5% you belong to? My lessons don't say who is 5% of this ballpark or this ballpark of the planet. They are a bunch of alcoholics and drunks. My lessons don't say that. My lessons say they are all wise and righteous and they know who the true and living God is, and they teach that the true and living God is the Son of Man. The supreme being, not the drunk being, not the alcoholic being, not the I can't wait to put a blunt in my mouth being. That's how my lessons don't tell me that. Maybe yours do. Maybe you got it all mixed up. Or if you got it mixed up, get it right. Damn it. Get it right. And stop killing yourself, man. Listen, you look around here, you see these seats, you know why you see these seats? Each one got to bring at least one, and it won't be one. And that goes for all of us. All of a sudden, if we bring one person with us a moment, the seats will not be like. We're becoming by ourselves, being good. We're coming by ourselves. We can't even bring one of our buddies along, or one of our sisters along, or one of our cousins along. Come on, man, come with me. Come hang with me. I want to show you something. You ever been to a universal father to the God? No, I never even heard of God. Well, come on, let me show you. Come on, hang out with me for a minute. I don't even have time. Come on, get somebody. Somebody to come get on the train with you, the bus with you, or get in your fancy ride with you. Come on down with you. Albert Dawson said, each one teach one. If each one in here brought one, these parliaments would not look like this in these seats we get to go. But my point is, God, today is not a bill. What we got to build, man. It's not a joke out here. My name is Solomon. Justice and equality, it says what? Supreme. Then it says after that. That's the first thing in our lessons, it says supreme. Let you know that this is the most high, not the most low. I mean, get it in your head, man. They say the black people is the most gullible ass people on the planet Earth. They look at us like we trash. So what we show them, that we trash. They say that we ain't good for nothing. So what are we doing? We showing them that we good for nothing. Is that what we showing them? Is that really what we really all about? We can't wait to show everybody that we is a bunch of bull crap people. Is that what the Bible said is supposed to be? I doubt it. And if you was for real, you better doubt your damn self. And I'm serious, and you know who I'm talking to, because you know the shoe fits you unaware because it fits you. Like I told you before, man, I'll bring a bed with you, I'll bring some table wine with you, but you ain't gonna get me to gobble down gin and rum and vodka and whiskey and all that crap and start falling all over the damn street like a jackass. And you ain't gonna get me to start sniffing all that bullshit up my nose. I did that for decades. And that ain't did nothing for me, my man. All it did was make me get cloudy and worse. Matter of fact, you start acting like a crack. And the vine, Father the vine said, even the crack addict is our brother and sister. Yes, they are. God said, come this wall. Yes, he did. But he didn't say, I was going to tell you to remain the same. He didn't say, come as a crack addict and remain a crack addict. He didn't say, come as a dope fiend and remain a dope fiend. Don't get it twisted. Y'all think that you're supposed to remain a drug addict? What the law said, he said, leave them damn drugs alone. When the father went home, a lot of them went back to being drug addicts. He didn't want that around them. And he told them, listen, the best way y'all gonna master this is to leave it alone. He did not say, like these knuckleheads will tell you, I'm a master it by dealing with it.
He's a fool.
As a matter of fact, show me a crack addict that masters crack. They out there selling their children, selling everything, stealing from their mama, stealing from their father, going to jail, coming back out and doing it all over again. How do you master that? Show me an alcoholic that's mastered that. Every morning he's up, he's shaking like a leaf, can't wait to get the next bottle, and then he's standing on the corner